Hello class 9. So we are discussing linear equation in two variable and we have already discussed exercise 4.1. So today let's start with exercise 4.2. So first of all, let us see what does solution mean, solution of a linear equation. Solution of linear equation. So let us take a simple linear equation x minus 1 equal to 2. So if we put the value of x as 6 and value of y as 4, so what do we get? 2 equal to 2. So here x equal to 6 and y equal to 4 can be called as the solution of this linear equation, because if you put 6 and 4, they satisfy, the equation is fully satisfied. Now let's take another example. If in place of 6, if we put 8, and in place of y, if you put 6, so what is the result? Again we get 2. So we can say that x equal to 8 and y equal to 6 is also a solution of the equation, because 8 minus 6 equal to 2. Again, 10 minus 8, what is the result? We get 2. So x equal to 10 and y equal to 8 can also be called as solution of the equation. Now 12 minus 10, what is the result? 2. So x equal to 12 and y equal to 10 is also the solution of equation. So what do you think, how many solution can a linear equation have? How many solutions can we make? There can be infinite solutions. Is that clear? There can be infinitely many solutions. So the first question, let's see. Which one of the following option is true and why? So y equal to 3x plus 5. What kind of equation is this? This is a linear equation, because the variable x is 1, the exponent of x is 1 and the exponent of y is 1. So it is clearly a linear equation. And how many variables are there? There are two variables, x and y. So which of the following option is true and why? Y equal to 3x plus 5 has unique solution, only two solution, or infinitely many solutions. So as I already told you that a linear equation in two variable can have infinitely many solution. So what is the correct option? The correct option is infinitely many solution. Why? Because for each unique value of x, you get a unique value of y. For each value of x, you get a value of y. Is that clear? Now let's see question number 2. Write 4 solution of each of the following equation. So the first equation is, so the first question is 2x plus y equal to 7. What you have to do is you have to write 4 solution. So let's see how we can find the solution of a linear equation. So in order to find out the solution of linear equation, what we have to do is we have to choose any value of x, or we can choose any value of y. For example, we can take x equal to 0, 1, 2. We can take any value of x, or we can take any value of y. Is that clear? So first of all, what is the given equation? The given equation is 2x plus y equal to 7, and we have to find 4 solution of this equation. So first of all, we will put x equal to 0. You can put y equal to 0, it's on you. So what will we get if you put x equal to 0? 2 into x means 2 into, in place of x we are going to put 0 plus y equal to 7. So what is 2 into 0? 2 into 0 is 0 plus y equal to 7, and ultimately we get y equal to 7. So on putting x, what do we get? Y is 7. So this value of x and y, they will be called as solution of the linear equation. Therefore, 0, 7 is the solution of the equation. So this is one solution, but we have to find three more solutions. So again, we can put x equal to 1, we can put y equal to 1, it's on us. Either we can put the value of x or value of y. So we put x equal to 1. Let's see what we get. So 2 into 1 in place of x, mind it, in place of x, what we have to put? 1. 2 into 1 plus y equal to 7. So 2 plus y equal to 7. Y equal to 7 minus 2. So ultimately we get y equal to 5. 7 minus 2, 5. So on putting x equal to 1, we get y equal to 5. So 1, 5 is the solution of the equation. Again, we can put x equal to 2. So when or we put x equal to 2, so 2 into in place of x we are going to put 2 plus y equal to 7. So 2 is 4 plus y equal to 7. So y equal to 7 minus 4. So we get y equal to 7 minus 4 is 3. So on putting x equal to 2, we get y equal to 3. So they become a set of equation solution. Therefore 2, 3. And remember, on writing the solution, we have to write, first of all, we have to write the value of x and then the value of y, and there should be comma in between. So 2, 3 is the solution of the equation. So last we put x equal to 3. So 2 into x in place of x will put 3 plus y equal to 7. 3 to just 6 plus y equal to 7, y equal to 7 minus 6, which implies y equal to 1. So on putting x equal to 3, we get y equal to 1. So 3, 1 is another set of equation. Therefore 3, 1 is the solution of the equation. So is that clear? So just now we have find fourth solution of the equation. So this is one set, 0, 7, then 1, 5, then 2, 3, and at last 3, 1. So this is this how we find out the solution of any equation. Okay, this three number will be your homework. What you have to do is, here x is alone, is that clear? So here I will suggest you not to put the value of x, just choose value of y, is that clear? If you choose y equal to 0, you get x equal to 0. If you take y equal to 1, so 4 into 1, x will be 4. So better take the value of y, is that clear? This will be your homework. Okay, now question number 2. you have to find fourth solution. The question is pi x plus y equal to 9. We have to find fourth solution of this equation. Okay, so the given equation is, what is the given equation? Pi x plus y equal to 9. So either we can put the value of y or value of x, it's up to us. So when x equal to 0, so pi into 0 plus y equal to 9, anything multiplied by 0 is 0, plus y equal to 9, so which implies y equal to 9. So we get one set of equation, 0 comma 9 is the solution of the equation. When x equal to 1, so pi into 1 plus y equal to 9, which implies pi into 1 is pi plus y equal to 9. So what is the value of y? Y equal to 9 minus pi. So how can we write 1 comma, this is the value of x, and what is the value of y? 9 minus pi. So 9 minus pi is the solution of the equation. Now when x equal to 2, so pi into 2 plus y equal to 9, 2 pi plus y equal to 9, so what we get? Pi equal to 9 minus 2 pi, if you take 2 pi on the right hand side. So therefore 2 comma 9 minus 2 pi is the solution of the equation. When x equal to 3, so pi into 3 plus y equal to 9, which implies 3 pi plus y equal to 9, which implies y equal to 9 minus 3 pi. So therefore 3 comma 9 minus 3 pi is the solution of the equation. So is that clear? So we just find out fourth solution. We just found out fourth solution, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is how we can find out the solution of any linear equation. Is that clear? You just put any value of x. You can take 1, 2, 3, 4, any value of x. Or either you can take any value of y. For each value of x, you will get a new value of y. Is that clear? And for each value of y, you will get a new value of x. Is that clear? So what do you think? How many solutions can a linear equation have? We can go on putting 3, x equal to 3, x equal to 4, x equal to 5. Is that clear? So we can get infinite many solutions. Okay. Now, as I have already told you that a solution always satisfies the equation. Is that clear? A solution will always satisfy a equation. For let's take an example, x plus y equal to 4. If you put x equal to 1, what do you get? y equal to 4 minus 1. This is an example, y equal to 3. So we can say that 1 comma 3 is the solution of the equation. Now what is the characteristics of this solution? This solution will always satisfy the equation. Means if you put 1 in place of x and 3 in place of y, do you find that LHS will always be equal to RHS? Is that clear? Check whether 2 comma 2 will be a solution or not. Yes, it will be, because if you put 2 and if you put y equal to 2, the result will be 4. So 2 comma 2 will also be the solution of equation. Now if we put x equal to 3 and y equal to 1, check whether it is a solution or not. It will be, because x equal to 3 plus 1 equal to 4 and 4 equal to 4, LHS is equal to RHS. Now if I say, is 5 comma 2 a solution of the equation? It will not be the solution, because if you put x equal to 5 and y equal to 2, So on left hand side you get 7 and on right hand side you get 4. So this will not be a solution. This will not be a solution. Is that clear? So if for solution, the equation must satisfy, the equation should be satisfied, that is LHS must be equal to RHS. So in question number 3, we can see that they have given a set of solutions, right? We have to check whether 0,2 is a solution or not for the linear equation. Is that clear? Because a linear equation can have infinite many solutions, okay? There is no question about that, but we have to check whether 0,2 is a solution of this equation or not. And as I've already told you, that a solution always satisfy any linear equation, a linear equation. That means LHS must be equal to RHS. So let's take the question. So first of all, let's see what is the given equation is x minus 2y equal to 4. In this case, we have to put x equal to 0 and y equal to 2, and then we have to check LHS and RHS. So we put x equal to 0 and y equal to 2. Now just put 0 minus, in place of x we will put 0, then minus 2 into, in place of y we will put 2 equal to 4. So 0 minus 4 equal to 4, which implies minus 4 equal to 4. Do you think that these both quantities are equal? No, it is negative and it is positive. So they are not equal. So what do you think, that is the equation satisfied in this case? No, the equation is not satisfied, right? So we can say that therefore, since LHS is not equal to RHS, therefore 0,2 is not a solution, is not a solution of the equation. Is that clear? Question number 2 will be homework. Let's see question number 3. So question number 3 is, we have to check for x equal to 4 and y equal to 0. We have to check whether 4,0 is a solution or not. So the given equation is x minus 2y equal to 4. So in third question, we put x equal to 4 and y equal to 0. Therefore 4 minus 2 into, in place of x we will put 4, in place of y we will put 0. 2 into 0 is equal to 4. So 4 minus 0 equal to 4, which implies 4 equal to 4. So here we see that LHS is equal to RHS. That means the equation is fully satisfied. Since LHS is equal to RHS, therefore 4,0 is the solution of the equation. And the remaining questions, these are very easy. You can just try it home. Is that clear? Now let's move to the last question of the exercise. Number 4. So what is the question? Find the value of k if x equal to 2 and y equal to 1 is a solution of the equation. Now, if x equal to 2 and y equal to 1, x equal to 2 and y equal to 1 is a solution of this equation, then x equal to 2 and y equal to 1 will satisfy this equation. Is that clear? That means we will just put x equal to 2 and y equal to 1 in this equation. Why we'll put these values? Because they are solution of the equation, and a solution always satisfy the linear equation. Is that clear? So first of all, write the given equation is, what is the given equation? The given equation is, what is the given equation? Let's see. 2x plus 3y equal to k. 2x plus 3y equal to k. We have to put x equal to 2 and y equal to 1. We put x equal to 2 and y equal to 1. So what we get? 2 into 2 plus 3 into 1. Equal to k. So 2 to the 4 plus 3 equal to k, which implies 7 equal to k, which implies k equal to 7. So the value of k is 7. So the rest question, the rest questions, please try it yourself. Okay, if you find any problem, just you can share your problem in the group.